Hi all, in this session we are going to see about the water demand estimation. The types of water demands are domestic demand, livestock demand, irrigation demand, the commercial and public places demand, institutional demand, industry demand and the fire demand. What is the need of the estimating water demand is to design the future water supply. It's a future demand is be estimated based on the population projection and also on the infrastructure and setup needed will depend on water demand to be fulfilled. What type of infrastructure is needed that should be planned based on the water demand. So the water demand estimation is important here. Underestimate leads to inadequate design, whereas overestimate results in an uneconomical and inefficient water supply system. So exact estimation of water demand is to ensure the adequate design of the water supply system. And what are the factors affecting water demand is climate, population, habits of people, or the cultural activities, which all interrelated with the water usage, and a crop type and a irrigation method and the field level method of water supply, industry and the commercial places, and the method of charging, that is the water price. And water price is very low, and then the water usage and wastage of water will be increased based on that. Pressure in distribution system also one of the major factor in water demand. The size of the city or town, it reflects the population again, and the system of supply and sanitation facilities and quality of water and the cost of water. A few points are repeated. The first thing and as an important one is a domestic demand. This is calculated based on the population. The per capita demand is estimated based on the people you needs the water in particular day. That will be specific for a country basis, state basis, and the region basis. Indian standard have 135 liters per capita state demand, and other countries have various demand pattern based on that drinking, bathing, and other activities which are comes for individual persons. And other industrial and institutional demands are also based on the population and also the standard, which standard is followed by which country. Based on that it will change. And the firefighting demand is different among these demands. That would be calculated based on these formulas. Four different formulas are there. Based on these formulas, the firefighting demand will be estimated. Some places this would be neglected. Based on the other demands will be huge. And this is a just analysis chart of India's water demand. Compared to the Europe and the overall world, India is spending more water on agriculture. And so only use of 5% for domestic and 12% for industry. That will be different to the European countries and also worldwide usage. Next to the domestic demand, the irrigation requirement is the major one. For that year I used one case study how to estimate the crop water requirement. We selected one river basin, and then in the river basin, within a river basin, we consider 20 irrigation projects, that means 20 reservoirs and their respective aycut area. For that, the meteorological data and cropping pattern of the data was received from the respective authority. The daily data was converted into monthly data, so followed by the monthly crop water requirement was estimated. For that, we used that crop 48 software, the open source. And then processing meteorological data and then temperature of maximum and minimum temperature and the rainfall data and also humidity of that particular location that will be used in a process. These are the project names, reservoir projects, and also influence IMD stations were identified and located. In this map, the green dots are the IMD stations, and also the yellow parts are the I-cut areas. The upstream of the I-cut area, that will be a project or reservoir will be there. So based on that, the Thiessen polygon was derived, and that influencing area was defined based on the Thiessen polygons. The meteorological data. This dialog box is came from the CropBot software. And the minimum temperature, maximum temperature, humidity, wind and sunshine hours are the input data here. That sunshine hours will be converted as a radiant, and also evapotranspiration, reference evapotranspiration was calculated here by the software. So rainfall data, the weighted average rainfall was used as a input in the software. After that, the CropBot will estimate the effective rainfall, and it will neglect the effective rainfall from the total irrigation demand. It's a rainfall and the effective rainfall, which is calculated based on these two formulas. Next one is crop data. That different crops have the different stages. Of days, the initial stage, development stage, and mid-season stage, and late season stage. Based on the crop, the water utilization and the stage period will be considered. So for that, we have to give a crop data. This is one of the crop name is gram. We have to enter the planting date. The harvesting data will be automatically calculated. And also KC coefficient values, coefficient of crop values will be entered. So initial stage, development stage, mid season, late season, and total days. Based on that coefficients will be entered. Here I missed out the soil data. You have to enter the soil data also. Which type of soil influencing in that particular I-cut area, that will be added. And then irrigation demand, it will be considered in a net irrigation and a gross irrigation. The net irrigation requirement will be crop water requirement minus effective rainfall. That will be the output from the crop water software. After that, we have to estimate the field irrigation requirement. What are the exact amount of water required for the particular field? That will be processed net irrigation equipment minus application efficiency and storage efficiency. And the gross irrigation requirement is field irrigation requirement divided by the conveyance efficiency. The output from the crop pot is the irrigation requirement, that is a net irrigation requirement, which is specifically required by the crop. After that, we have to process this net irrigation requirement into the gross irrigation requirement. That would be a exact demand of that crop. It's a process. Here the month and the types of different crops for a particular project was considered. Here net irrigation requirement, which is taken from the CropBot software, that will be converted into gross irrigation requirement. So total irrigation requirement is 2131 million meter cube. That will be the total irrigation demand for the particular UKP project command area. And here is the representation of demand for a different crops. This is an example for only single project. Like that, we have to calculate for each and every individual project, and that would be considered for the water accounting and the water supply for the particular project. And This crop data will be available in that crop or software itself. For few crops only available in default. If you want to add more, we can create the crops. That will be explained in the next hands-on session, how to add the new crop data, new soil data, and how to use the default data itself. That will be explained in that hands-on. And other demands like livestock demand. This also standard value available with respect to the different countries standards. For a livestock, the three different types of there: major, medium, and minor. Based on that, per day demand will be defined in IS standards, also on American standards. That will be different. That is not specific in any value here. So you have to follow that standard values for that livestock demand and domestic demand. Irrigation demand will be calculated based on the crop earth software, and the commercial and public places for parks and commercial malls, wherever public places and commercial buildings, the demand of water also specified by the standards only. It also differ with respect to the country and the region, and institutional also same as like that. Industry demand may be changed based on that production, but the policy makers have the percentage of water, how much want to supply for that any industry, that will be considered. Demand and supply may be changed, but here we have to consider what is the allowable water to a particular industry by the government or any policy makers. That will be considered here. And that fire demand, already we seen that we have to use that formulas for calculating the fire demand. These are the major demands. Some of other demands also there, that will be most of the cases negligible. In that also we have to consider only domestic and livestock and irrigation and industry. That four are the major and important demands we have to consider for any hydrological analysis or water accounting. That's all. We will see the hands-on next session.